The milestone for this week is a pile of materials. At this point, you have put together a lot of exercises over the course of the four different courses in the specialization. You're not going to be able to use all of it. An important thing for you to be thinking about is, well, which to set aside and which you really want to keep. What kinds of material are we talking about? Well, certainly the exercises will be parts of it, but little scraps of paper that you have hanging around in your drawer, in your mind, on your computer, that they're sort of embryonic ideas. Also, any sketches that you might have made of scenes or details that you've put together that maybe you didn't even use in any of the exercises. Really, anything at all. I want you to make a pile of some kind. Now, it's not important really right now, it's not necessary right now that you only pick material that coheres. We're only looking at this point for promising stuff. If you want to get going right away from the first page, you're perfectly welcome to do that, of course, but I hope just as a milestone that you'll have on your desk, as it were, a pile of material. Now, a metaphor that I like to think of for this stage comes from making bread. If you were making a loaf of bread, first of all, you'd have the flour, you'd have the salt, you'd have leavening of some kind, you'd have water. These materials aren't inherently, they don't immediately make a dough all of their own. But there's an important step between mixing and a kneaded dough that might be useful for us to think about. In a book about bread baking I read once, they refer to this as a shaggy mass. That is, once you mix the flour and the water and the salt together, you get something that's a sort of clumpy thing that you can pour out of the bowl before you start kneading it. That shaggy mass is sort of what we're going for here. You don't have to worry too much about kneading it just yet. Let's just try to get all the materials in one place. So that's the assignment for this week. Assemble your materials and start composing. Next week, we'll have a little bit more to say about strategies for composition and getting that material into a more coherent form.